It's hot.
Good afternoon and welcome to At Radio Hull. This is Soap Week. Coming up straight after this first track, we have A Week in Weatherfield. He's Anita Dobson. Anyone can fall in love.
Compare the Meerkat.com toys proudly sponsor Coronation Street.
Hi, welcome to A Week in Weatherfield, the Coronation Street review show presented by two people who've read
all the dirty bits in Kayla's diary about Craig. I'm David Brown.
And I'm Jonathan Hughes.
This week's headlines: Simon's Life of Crime,
Weatherfield Wedding Bells,
and Super Susie. Okay, well, poor Simon's just had his knuckles scraped down the wall, hasn't he, by, what's he called, Tyler?
Tyler, that's such a bad teen name, yeah. Isn't it, Tyler?
Not that they look like teens.
Tyler's 42. This is my theory. Tyler is like... Maybe because Simon looks so weeny for his age.
Yeah, yeah.
Compared to him, Tyler's really tall and looks older than me.
Yeah, they look like the T-Birds on Grease.
Well, and all the T-Birds were about 42. Like, John Travolta must have been... Was no 17-year-old in that film.
Kinnicky had a receding hairline.
Kinnicky was growing his pension. Yeah. Much like Tyler probably is. So he's going to be... Well, he's gone from being a very willing criminal to now, like, oh, I don't really want to do it.
I know.
Oh, my knuckles. Oh. Yeah.
One attack on Flora and he suddenly can try it.
I know.
It's all it takes.
Never bothered with Flora.
I know. But I was kind of rooting for Simon to become this all-out villain, because now that he's getting older, he's starting to look like Dominic West,
yes,
playing Fred West in that ITV drama. So I was kind of hoping that he would kind of go all-out villain.
All-out villain.
Yeah. Resemblance is there, yeah, unfortunately.
They've got a similar hair, like the wig Dominic West had on.
Yes.
Is this like a subliminal, like, you know...
This is what we're supposed to be thinking.
Yeah, like... Simon's really going to be this evil character growing up, perhaps.
I think in 10 years' time, you know, Dominic West should be recast as Simon. That'd be brilliant, wouldn't it? So, yeah, Flora, she came a bit of a cropper. She was kind of, you know...
She was the victim of Simon's crime, mate.
Yeah. But she had a funny old week, Flora, hadn't she?
She hadn't had a good week at all. She had to go and identify... My Harvey.
And she said that he looked peaceful.
Really?
But...
What happened to Harvey? Just remind us.
Yeah, he was shot in the head.
Yes.
He was buried in a lake and
yes,
then dumped in a vat of concrete, liquid concrete.
Oh, he looks so peaceful. The way his eyeballs have been melted and all that concrete had seeped into the cadavers of his face.
His skin was like the texture of a lychee. That's what it would have been like.
Talking of lychees, oh, Sinead, you popped down the Chinese. I'm a bit peckish after the morgue.
She seems to have kind of made it up with Sinead now. She's all for the wedding. She's all for the wedding between...
She's all for the wedding. She gave the family heirloom engagement ring. I am disappointed that she likes Sinead, because I loved her sniping, calling her Chenille.
Yes, that was really funny. Yes. Yeah. I mean, are we convinced by Daniel and Sinead? Do we like them as a couple?
I think they're like a young Ken and Deirdre,
yeah,
aren't they? Because you've got Daniel as Ken, you know, the kind of at the same at the age, you know, Ken was when we kind of met him. He's the frustrated intellectual, kind of trapped in this working class backstreet that he doesn't want to be in. And then you've got Sinead is just the girl next door, a kind of ordinary girl, but with...
She does have ambitions, though, doesn't she?
She does have ambitions. So she's got this kind of extraordinary...
The soap business.
Yeah. So, I'm going to make some soaps. Does she like soaps anymore?
I don't know, she used to.
Pre-bus crash. Maybe it's too traumatic. She can't make bus crash. So, yeah, they're kind of like a regular working class girl next door and an intellectual with highfalutin ideas. So you can kind of see they're setting that up.
Mm-hmm.
I don't think it's the most scintillating couple and engagement in the world.
Or even
in Weatherfield.
More fun, though.
Much more fun, though, with Steve and Tracy getting engaged.
Yes.
By complete fluke. Now, I'm loving this because I feel Corrie are starting a new tradition for us. Do you know how Super Soap Week happens in May?
Yes.
Someone gets blown up in the factory or wherever. So every year, I think Steve McDonald should have a misunderstood summer proposal.
Yeah.
This time last year, he got engaged to Leanne in a complete, like, you know, comedy of errors thing.
Who could it be next year, then?
Eccles.
Yeah, I do.
I'll be wife number 28.
Yes. Flipping it! Just got engaged to the dog!
Steve was wearing Kevin Webster's purple bomber jacket when he was proposing
as well. What does that tell us?
Yeah, why doesn't Kevin want that back? Have you noticed?
Kevin was attached to that for decades.
Yeah, he's giving it up without a second thought.
It's like handing over a very important piece of Corrie history.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's funny that you mention a flipping it, though. Because
flipping it!
That's Steve's kind of swearing substitute word,
yeah,
isn't it?
Yeah, it's the pre-water watershed curse, isn't it? Yeah.
Eva's got one of those as well. Have you noticed what hers is?
How many times does Eva say the word piggin?
She says it at least three times an episode.
Pigginometer, Eve's flip projector. Oh, Ty, will you just wind your piggin neck in? Piggin hell.
This week, that piggin baby managed to roll off the piggin sofa.
It's a piggin super baby, that! That baby is, what, weeks old?
Yeah, it's bionic. It's like Kal-El from Superman. It's going to be lifting up Mary's motorhome next week.
It's from Krypton. Yeah. Never mind who's getting custody of the baby. The baby fell from Krypton because it's superpowered.
Yeah. Krypton.
Oh, I've seen Super Piggy Man and all this ends. I think, Susie's going to grow up be outrunning trams along the viaduct.
Leaping speed dial in a single bound. Yeah.
Oh, and then they're going to grow up and get a job on the Weatherfield Recorder under a seat, like wearing big glasses with a fake identity.
I think we've definitely got something here.
Piggin' hell.
You can join us in 7 days' time to find out whether, never mind the custody fight between Johnny and Eva, I think General Zod's going to be throwing his hat into the ring. We'll be back with another week in Weatherfield.
Yeah, there's more from Weatherfield coming up next, straight after this one from the Black Eyed Peas and The Town.
This is International Big Mega Radio Smasher.
I had the time of my life, and I never felt this way before. And I swear this is true, and I owe it all to you.
Oh, I had the time of my life, and I never felt this way before. And I swear this is true, and I owe it all to you.
Dirty bit.
Dirty bit.